pandemic years were extremely difficult for the global business travel market. More so in the Philippines, where extended travel restrictions and strict health protocols severely affected the industry, business hotels especially. But as the economy continues to reopen, hotels are seeing a steady rise in bookings, while those that delayed their launch are starting to welcome guests. The newest one of which is the Admiral Hotel Manila M Gallery, a five-star luxury boutique managed by the French Accor Hotels, the first M Gallery property in the Philippines. The property across Manila Bay is located exactly where the historic Admiral Hotel once stood, in what was then Dewey Boulevard. And though the height and facade of the new Admiral is a replica of the original, the interiors have been redesigned completely to channel the days when the Bayfront Hotel was a watering hole of Manila high society and political elite.
Perhaps the days when all a business traveler expected from a hotel is a good and predictable place to eat, sleep, and work are over. Because with business travel put on hold for 2 years and video conferencing creating less opportunities to fly overseas, those that do travel for business are trying to maximize their trips now more than ever and choosing hotels that offer a more unique experience and a sense of place.
From the Spanish room where guests are welcome before checking into their rooms to the grand atrium and lobby. The interiors featuring reliefs of street scenes of the old city, the colorful art ceiling, the reinterpreted Machuca tiles, and the traditional banderilla balconies combine to transport guests to a different, more gracious era of Manila's history. Las Páginas de la Historia, an art installation in the lobby, takes one down memory lane through literal pages of history and to a time when Manila was called the Pearl of the Orient, the Jewel of the Pacific. The journey into local culture continues in the upper floors and in all of the hotel's 123 guest rooms.
Each floor of the property has a different Filipino theme. The third floor example, it's Filipino national heroes. So let's check out the General Suite. It's their executive suite. Which means that no two rooms in the property are alike. I love it.
Manila Bay may look different than it was in its heyday. Dewey Boulevard is now called Rojas. But the view of the rehabilitated Baywalk and the skyline of the city are stunning nevertheless from the Admiral Club's poolside bar and terrace.
The Admiral Club is where all the dining takes place, from breakfast all the way to dinner and everything in between. But of course, very soon they'll be opening up a new F&B outlet.
Orchestrating the hotel's food and beverage offerings is Manila-based French executive chef Cyril Sonnen, who, as most local gourmands remember, has helmed the kitchens of Manila's top hotels throughout his illustrious culinary career.
What is this?
This is a blackberry yuzu lemonade.
Wow, nice. Interesting combination of blackberry and yuzu.
Yes.
Apart from another restaurant and a spa that's still to open, plus a number of rooms that are under construction, the Admiral Hotel Manila M Gallery is now officially open. While more new hotels are expected to open soon, others like the Shangri-La de Fort have used the pandemic years to reassess, refresh, and relaunch their offerings.
First of all, business travel is coming back a lot faster than we expected. And I think after two and a half years of not being physically in contact with their teams, CEOs are starting to travel, and that's fueling travel of other executives. And as they continue to come back to business hotels, their expectation is really to have all the facilities open. And from our end, we are trying to rehire and retrain coming out of a long period of the hotel being closed and without guests to match up with these expectations and to have all the services open for them.
The reopening of the Horizon Lounge, the Shangri-La's executive lounge, is the latest in a series of new concepts being introduced to cater to the changing expectations of business travelers, like the need for private space.
Well, you know, the Horizon Lounge becomes like a refuge for the business travelers. So they have a space where, they have some privacy and some quiet so they can do work. I think prior to COVID, there was less of video calls compared to now. So people need more space where they can, out of their guest rooms, right? So while the guest rooms are well equipped for you to work there, no one really wants to be in the guest room the whole day. And the hotel offers many other locations where you can do that, but the lounge is really ideal for that kind of traveler where you can get privacy to make your calls, do your work, and be supported by the hotel staff for your business needs.
Likewise, to promote safety and improve time management by upgrading their business amenities, support staff, conference rooms, and food and beverage offerings, the new Horizon Lounge reduces the need for travelers to hold meetings in separate locations within the hotel or around the city. The Shangri-La has also noticed that business travelers are staying longer, perhaps to compress multiple trips or make up for lost time. Either way, the hotel has responded by creating new experiences to keep them productive and entertained without having to leave the premises.
The pandemic created all sorts of challenges for the hospitality industry, but it's also created new opportunities as well. The Keep, for example, is an innovative dining concept as a product of the changes in the behavior of diners and clients. Let's see what it looks like. Wow, they've got a private bar, and a private dining area. Now all this used to be just another generic meeting room in the property. And now look at it. It's a private dining and party space.
The Keep around the corner from the popular Raging Bull restaurant is like the hotel's very own speakeasy, with privacy guaranteed because it can only be booked by a single party. With many still reluctant to return to crowded bars, this is a great way to enjoy cocktails in the comfort and safety of your own private and customizable hangout.
We're using our own Raging Bull whiskey, which we aged in this barrel here for 3 months. And then we added this Napoleon liqueur. Go. We smoke it.
Yeah, I smell the smoke, okay.
There you go.
So I'm sure you agree this is really such a great idea, having your own private bar for cocktails with friends and family. But it doesn't end here. Nope, the Keep experience continues behind that door. This is where all the dining takes place. Thank you so much. And this is the dining room. If you're familiar with Raging Bull next door, it's got a similar vintage vibe, but I'm told a lot of original features as well. I have to remind you that you just can't walk in here and expect to be served like the restaurant next door. No, you have to book in advance, and because it's so popular, maybe way in advance. But the upside is, you have this place all to yourself. And of course, you get to order stuff that's off the menu, or even from the other outlets of Shangri-La.
Naturally, because the kitchen is attached to Raging Bull, steaks are the Keep's specialty. Although, you can always customize the menu and the wine list. Even personalize the space, like pick your own decor or table settings. Something that will be too difficult to do in any of the other restaurants of the hotel.
This is such a great idea. It's like having your own private dining room and bar. in your own home, but with a raging bull as your private kitchen. I love this idea.
As much as I'm loving this Saint Emilion paired with premium cuts of Australian beef. Sure, you can get good wine and steaks elsewhere, but for safety-conscious business travelers on a tight schedule, having the flexibility to work, meet, and entertain all in the same place is an increasingly attractive option these days.